Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we are going to see about what is aggregated table in Power BI. This is one of the important performance improvement factor when you have a huge set of data and your Power BI reports takes too long to load, or the while querying it takes some kind of performance degradation you're seeing, and you see it is because of huge data. There are different ways of handling it. One way is to create aggregated table and loading it instead of directly loading the table. Let us try to check what I'm trying to say in this video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button to learn the concepts in Power BI and press the bell icon for the notification. We are in Power BI now. We can see here, this is one set of table where it is directly connected to the source, SQL source, and there is a simple model. It is connected to the product. So you have a lot of columns here in this table, and this particular report doesn't use much of your columns. Like when you see here, sales amount, profit, and by category, and then by year and order type. So almost it doesn't use more than 4 to 6 columns. When you see here, it contains more than 10 to 12 columns. So either you can delete those rows, that is absolutely fine. That will be very much useful, whichever is not used. But another way of doing is like removing these columns, it's very good. And one another point is like you are still getting all the rows. Assume this particular table contains 2 million rows, and you are still bringing 2 million rows for those 6 to 7 columns. Instead, for your reports, if your report doesn't require detailed analysis, you want to see only the high level or aggregated data, then you can use group by of all the categorical column and then use appropriate aggregations for your numerical column, then bring only that aggregated table here. In that way, you can improve the performance. Let me tell you what I'm trying to say. So now I go here and I can see the table over here where it is pointing to the particular database from this particular Nagastro database and sales data. So I did some transformations here. Still I removed some columns and changed some data types. Instead of bringing the table as such, whatever columns used for my report, right? So that is location, sales date, order type, then followed by product name, product category. That's it. These are the categorical column I'm using in my report. So I can see like group by. When you choose group by, then all these columns becomes a group by attributes. Then what to be aggregated? I want to aggregate sales amount, then it should be same column sales amount. I can keep it, keep the name as such, sales amount, add aggregation. Another column is sum of tax amount. Where is that? I think it's a profit, not a tax amount, it's profit. So these are the columns I'm using in my report. That's it. Now you can see I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 categorical column, 2 numerical columns, that is my measures. And I can bring this particular aggregated table. Now this becomes aggregated table. When your source is from SQL or SQL database, then you can write this kind of group by operation at your source itself, right? So click on close and apply. There you go. Then you can see here there won't be any changes unless you disturb any of the columns, existing columns. So everything loaded properly. You have only aggregated table with reduced columns. In this way, you can improve the performance. And also you can reduce this granularity of day to month if it is possible, that is beginning of the month, so that further you will reduce the cardinality of your this particular column. So in that way you can improve the performance. This particular method or approach suitable only if your report doesn't require a detailed data. Now your report requires some detail analysis, drill through, want to see the receipt number, then this is not possible here. When you want to have that report receipt number or detail analysis to be seen, and then you want aggregations also enabled, then wait for my next video, that will be in part 2. Now this approach suitable for import or the direct query mode. The table currently I use is import mode. Either you can choose to direct query mode as well, right? So this is what I want to highlight about aggregation and aggregation tables. Let us check the part 2 of aggregations table, when to use, in what scenarios you will go for other options in my next video. If you like this video, hit the subscribe button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.